You know, if you've been looking for a great craft project, a rainy Monday is a perfect day to do something like that. Our first guest is going to show us how to use seasonal flowers to make one-of-a-kind jewelry. We welcome Richmond floral designer Dina King back to our show. Hi, Dina.
Hi, thanks
good
for having
me. Good to see you. This is a great project if somebody maybe has the day off or decided to play hooky and wants to stay in and do something. Bill laughed at me when I talked about making clover necklaces and bracelets when we were a kid, but this is kind of just an adult extension of that.
Yes, definitely. This is kind of a new, more modern way to wear flowers on your wrist rather than the old school elastic, you know, wristlet corsages.
Mm-hmm, the corsages. So this is something that a young lady could, if she was going to something special, mm-hmm. could make her own special jewelry. Mm-hmm. Is this going to last longer than a couple of days?
We definitely try to use things that are more longer lasting that will hold up. Most people for weddings or proms or special occasions only care that it looks good for that, you know, evening, but uh-huh. we can definitely use more longer lasting items for
now,
them.
Now, if we were going to do something like that for a prom or a wedding or a special occasion, is that something that we have to make that day so that it's going to hold up?
We usually make them the day before. We just keep them in the floral cooler, which keeps them nice. As long as they're kept somewhere cool where there's not like a heat source, they hold up pretty well.
Well, let's talk about some of the raw ingredients that you brought today. What do we have?
Okay, so I love just really natural green things. Mm-hmm. So I brought some parvifolia. This is grevillea. Right here is called podocarpus. I know they're really simple names to remember.
I know, it's like, I won't remember any of those. This looks kind of fernish.
Yes, it is. It is a type of fern.
I know fern.
This is brunia, safari, agapanthus, trichdianthus. This is a scabiosa pod. This is a strontia, ranunculus, hypericum, seeded eucalyptus. These are called hens and chicks. They're a type of succulent. Mm-hmm. These are air plants. And this is just little leaves off of a peperomia plant.
You get an A+ for all those
pronunciations.
Good job there.
Thank you.
And these are things that we can kind of mix and match. I love the colors, a lot of greenery. Mm-hmm. And then we have a base that we're going to put them on.
Yeah, these they just call a blank. And you can buy them gold, silver. They come in lots of different, you know, types of textures and colors.
I call those Diana bracelets because they look like Wonder Woman.
Yes. Who doesn't want to be Wonder Woman,
exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
So you can decide just based on your design, and we do workshops where you can make your own floral jewelry as well, but sometimes we'll, depending on how much someone wants, we might cover the whole bracelet from left to right. Today we're going to start and we're going to kind of do a diagonal pattern going mm-hmm. across. So your main thing that you need to have is this Oasis floral adhesive, mm-hmm. and it's real easy to use. The key to making it stick really well is once you put it on something, you need to just let the air hit it for a couple of seconds and then put it down.
Okay, so we don't want to glue and stick right away.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So I was going to start with a little piece of this fern, and I thought it would be kind of pretty to have hanging over the edge of the bracelet.
Oh, nice.
So I will just put a little bit. You don't need a ton. I'll just put it on there and kind of just let the air hit it for a second.
And you were saying that you do workshops to teach people how to do this.
Definitely. They're a lot of fun. We have scheduled workshops on our website where you can actually sign up right online for them.
Mm-hmm. That would make it like a good girls' day
out. Oh, yeah. It's so much fun. We have a really good time. And then we also let people do private workshops as long as there's five or more people. They can schedule their own time and subject area. And
so maybe if you were going to do it for a wedding
or
girls getting together for a prom, you could all go and learn how to do it together.
Right. And it would be a lot of fun to make them the day before, and then you would actually wear what you made.
Mm-hmm.
So for homecoming would be fun, which we're in the throes of right now, and prom and all of those events. So I'm just kind of starting with the base with this fern.
Now, is that glue waterproof? Because I notice you're getting it on your hands.
Yes.
So how do you get that off afterwards?
I hate even telling you this, but I use WD-40.
Okay, something that's
something
got a petroleum
really healthy
base.
For your skin.
Yeah. Well, you're not going to put a lot on there.
No.
Now, okay, so you've got the succulents there mm-hmm. that are going on.
I'm going to just put a little glue spot on that one and let it sit
a
minute. And I'm going to put a little on the peperomia.
And this is really where your own imagination comes in and your own style.
Right, and the key I feel like for these is lots of layering. The more layering of different objects that you use, the more interesting the bracelet is. Mm-hmm. I mean, you could make one of these in 3 minutes by just, you know,
popping things on.
Yeah, exactly. But for our intent and purpose, we want to make it a little more special. So I'm going to use some of these pieces of the air plant also.
Now, how would the bigger pieces, like, I don't remember what you call this, but how would that stick on there?
That's a ranuncula. We would cut the stem completely off, mm-hmm. and it would just lay flat. This one's a little large. Okay. I would probably go smaller, and that was a great question, because that's another really good key component to these, is using stuff that is as small as possible, mm-hmm. because then you can put on more things as you go along. So I would have this guy kind of coming out, and I would put a few more of these under here. I'm just, for the sake of time, mm-hmm. trying to...
That's really unique and very beautiful.
Yeah, and another really cool thing to do is to use parts of flowers mm-hmm. to kind of disassemble them. So this agapanthus has these really pretty purple blooms on it. You would never stick this whole flower on here.
Yeah,
then you'd be done, and you're like,
that's right.
Yeah.
Bracelet.
So if you kind of take flowers apart, it's really cool to see what you can come up with, because then this becomes a smaller component to mm-hmm. fill up space, but it doesn't take up the whole bracelet. Along with something like this on the Brunia, you can use these the ball part, but you can also take these apart, the little...
Because you're creating texture.
Exactly right. And then you can add more texture to your bracelet by putting on, you know, different things.
Well, that's absolutely beautiful, Dina. Yeah. Thank you for showing us how to do this today.
You're so
Dina
welcome.
King is offering several workshops, including the Autumn Everlasting Floral Crown Workshop next week on Wednesday, October 25th. That's at 6:30 at Blue Bee Cider. The Floral Crown Tea Party is November 7th from 6 to 8 at Strawberry Fields Flowers and Vines. And we'll put a link with all the details on our show website at WTVR.com/VTM. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
I've got a new project for a rainy day.